Welcome to the Audio Laboratory. In a good production, the settings of your tracks, instruments, and effects are rarely just set and forget. You want them to change across time to keep things interesting and dynamic. Maybe you want to emphasize certain parts of the arrangement or introduce some variation. Has this ever happened to you? You want to record a song, so you invite some friends over to help you with the parameter changes? Okay, before you play the lead line for a second time, you turn up the volume by 3 decibels, raise the filter cutoff, and don't forget to turn down the delay mix a tad. Right before the bass starts, you will create a riser by filtering some noise. When the bass starts playing, I will slowly raise the drum machine volume until the kick sets in. The rest is pretty self-explanatory. And go! Stop. That was 4 decibels. We said 3 decibels, remember? Hey! Well, that's what you get for trusting humans with your parameter automation. Let's take a look at how this can be done way easier in the digital audio workstation. The drums draw a little too much attention at the beginning while the bass is playing. We want the drums to start at a lower volume and then gradually become louder. In Reaper, you just have to select a track and press V on the keyboard to show its volume automation envelope. To add points to this envelope, you hold Ctrl while clicking on it. You can move points by dragging them. You can also drag whole segments up and down. If you want to delete a point, hold Alt while clicking it. You can work with more than one point at the same time if you drag a selection with your right mouse button. But our adjustment will be very simple. So, let's clear the envelope and start again. We want the volume to start at about -6 decibels and then gradually become louder. We only need 2 points. Here's a tip. If you want a point to only move along one axis, you can hold Ctrl and Shift. This way, you can adjust its value without moving it in time. Or the other way round. So, we can use automation envelopes to describe how parameters should change over time. But we're not limited to volume automation. On the riser track, we have a synthesizer that basically just generates some noise with a few effects on top. We want to use the synthesizer's filter cutoff to create a snappy noise sweep after the intro. So we're going to automate this fader. On the drums, we added the volume envelope with a shortcut. But if we want to see more options, we need to click the track's automation button. These are all the parameters we can automate. Some universal ones like volume and pan, but also every parameter of every plugin on this track. This list can be a bit overwhelming, but fortunately, there's a search function here. But what's even better, we can let Reaper show us only the last parameters that were touched inside of the plugins. That makes them really easy to find. So, let's program the filter movement right around these notes. But that doesn't sound right yet. We need something snappier instead of this even movement. By default, the points on an envelope are connected by a straight line. That was okay for the drum volume adjustment, but here we need something different. When right-clicking a point, you have the option to change its shape. The point shape tells the envelope how to transition from this point to the next one. Let's see what's available. Linear is the default. Square will give you an abrupt change with no transition at all. Slow start end has a fairly linear middle with a smooth start and end. Fast start will give you a curve where the biggest change happens at the beginning. And fast end is a curve with the biggest movement towards the end. This one comes close to what I had in mind. The last option is called Bezier. In fact, you automatically get this one when you hold the Alt key and drag an envelope segment. This way, you can freely adjust the curve tension using the mouse. As you can hear, Small adjustments make a big difference in this case. On the lead synth, I already programmed 3 automation envelopes. When the lead melody is played for the second time, there's a little less delay, the filter cutoff is raised to make it brighter, and the volume goes up a bit as well. If your project becomes cluttered with too many automation envelopes, you can also hide them. They can still be active though, so don't get confused when your parameters suddenly change out of nowhere. What's really cool is that you can create an automation item out of any part of your envelope. You can then loop this automation item, and every change you make to it is propagated throughout the loop. Here I'm using it on a volume envelope to achieve a rhythmic staccato effect. You could also use this technique on a pan envelope to create a panning tremolo. And finally, this last chord has a delay with a high feedback level on it. Without any adjustment, it would just keep repeating well beyond the end of the song. If we want to suppress any repeats after this point, we can simply reduce the feedback to 0. With automation, you can give your production the fine-tuning and variation it needs. You could use it to balance track levels between chorus and verse, even out vocal performances, give more reverb or delay to certain parts, and so much more. Automation lets you orchestrate as many changes as you want. That's it for this flashcard. Don't hesitate to leave a comment. And if you want to see more videos like this one, subscribe and ring the bell.
Bunny.